This is going to be an instructional video to show you how to program your Labnet pipette for use with the Diffinity RapidTip or RapidTip2. First, a basic layout of the pipette. On the front of the unit, you have 5 gray buttons, 4 of which I will be referring to throughout this video. This is your back button, your down and up arrow button, your enter button, and your unit reset button. This blue lever is your tip ejection. On the back of the unit, you have a finger rest, an aspirate and dispense button, and a battery case removal button. Before we begin the programming process, we need to make sure that our pipette is in the automatic function. To do this, press the back button. There will be 5 icons that will show up at the top of the screen. The one that is currently flashing is selected. Using the down or up arrow buttons, scroll over to automatic and click enter. The Diffinity RapidTip is utilized for a 25 microliter sample volume. However, you will need to over-aspirate to 50 microliters to allow your liquid to flow past the retainer and allow for proper mixing and purification. For the RapidTip2, it is utilized for a 50 microliter sample volume. You will need to, however, over-aspirate to 60 microliters for the same reasons. For this video, we will set up the pipette as if we were setting up for the RapidTip. So we will set our aspirate and dispense volume to 50 microliters. If you were using a RapidTip2, you would set this to 60. You would use the up and down arrow buttons to get to your desired volume. After you've selected it, click enter. And now we can begin the actual programming process. To begin the programming process, we will need to click the back button again, and those 5 icons will show up. This time, using the down arrow, we will scroll over to SYS and click enter. Now your aspirate speed will be flashing. The Diffinity RapidTip and RapidTip2 perform best with slow aspirations and slow dispenses. So using your down arrow button, we will select the slowest aspirate speed, which is 1 bar as you can see. Click enter, and now your dispense speed will be showing. Again, using the down arrow button, we will select 1 bar and click the enter button. This is just a sound icon. Basically, when you aspirate and dispense, this icon will have it where either your unit will make a noise when you aspirate and dispense or not. You can choose whether or not you want it on or off with the down or up arrow buttons. Doesn't really matter. Next, a pipette icon will be flashing. As you can see, there is an arrow pointing down towards the tip. This shows that the blowout feature is enabled. We will not be using the blowout feature until our last aspirate and dispense cycle. So using the up or down arrows, we will disable the blowout feature. As you can see, there is no arrow. And we click the enter button. A second pipette icon will be flashing. As you can see, no arrow. And we will click enter. Make sure there is no arrow. A program icon will be flashing. Leave it be. Just hit enter. Set a timer for 60 seconds, and using the button on the back, as I showed before, aspirate and dispense. Also, after each aspiration and dispense, you should wait 4 seconds to allow the liquid to completely flow into the RapidTip and completely empty out of the RapidTip, as shown here. You aspirate, wait 4 seconds, and dispense. And all of that is just controlled, like I just said, with this button. So after your 60 seconds is up and your timer is going off, you'll need to perform 1 last aspirate and dispense cycle. We will need to turn on the blowout feature that we disabled in our previous programming. To do this, click the back button. Using the down arrow, select SYS again. All your previous settings have been saved, so simply click enter until you reach your first pipette flashing icon. And this time we want the arrow to be pointing down the pipette, and we want it to be shown. Like I said, this will enable the blowout feature. So on your last cycle, it will aspirate normally, and when you dispense, all the liquid will be blown out of your tip, hence blowout. Click the enter button, click the enter button, and like I said, just aspirate and dispense normally, and you're good to go. If you have any questions, feel free to call our customer service line at 1-877-362-1812 or visit us on the web at www.definitygenomics.com.